This tutorial is going to show you how to mess with the logo image and make it a little bit more interesting in terms of how to animate it in a video editing software. So the first thing we're going to do is to go to my background layer here, and you notice it's locked because it is the background layer. So I'm going to either right click on this or just click and drag it down to the little layer icon here. Looks like a little page, and that's going to make a copy. And then I can either make this background invisible by clicking on the little eyeball, or I can just delete it out. And in this case, I just want to delete it out. Once I've made a change like this, I want to immediately save it as a different kind of software. So I'm going to go to File, and then I'm going to go to Save As, and I'm going to save this as a Photoshop file. There we go. So you want to maximize compatibility, click OK, and now you've got a Photoshop file. This might really not seem any different to you, but it will be useful later on. So from here, what I need to do is pull out all of these different colors as separate layers, and there's a few ways to do this. One of the easiest ways to do it is to use the marquee tool, which is this little square, and you can go through and you can select things like this area here that's a square or a rectangle, and then pull it out. So once it's highlighted, I can right-click on it, or I can go to Layer via Copy, or I can go up to the top to Layer, and then New, and then via Copy. And what this is going to do is it's going to make another layer, I'll turn this invisible, that is just that piece. And the nice thing about this is that if you zoom in on this, you can see some irregularities in the color. So you can see that I've got a little bit of a problem here, and then I've got some white there in the gradient. But you'll notice that that comes with this as long as I've cut it out right. And that's a nice thing. So that's what I want at this point. I'm going to leave this layer invisible just because it'll make it easier to see what I'm doing. So from here, I need to take out the black. And there's a bunch of ways to do this. The marquee obviously is not going to work. You could use, if you hold down the magic wand tool, you can go to the magic wand or the quick selection. In this case, magic wand is probably a good idea because it's pretty much the same color. And you can choose your tolerance up here. So I want things to be mostly black, so 32 is okay. And notice I should be selected. When I selected this, it selected everything because that's my layer one. So we select it onto the background. And then I can go through and select this piece. And then I can, and you can see it's left out this little piece of white here. And I can hold down shift, and then I can add these little pieces in. And then I could get eventually a pretty representative sample of what I want. And you could mess with your tolerance a little bit to add or subtract little pieces here. That's kind of a pain in the ass, so I'm not going to do that. I'm going to deselect, and I'm going to go to Select instead and go to Color Range. And from here, you can see as long as I'm on the right layer, you can see where I'm going. And I've got a little eyedropper, so I'm going to select black again. And then you can choose how fuzzy it is. If it's not fuzzy, it's going to give you only things that are pure black, which is only this middle. And then I can add my fuzziness in here, and then I'll get more of those details. It's not going to give you a perfect match, but it'll come pretty close. And so this is fine. So I'm going to click OK, and you'll see it's going to select almost everything. Again, it's not going to get really deeply in there. So you can see that when I get close, it's going to leave out these little artifacts. And to get those back, I would have to do another select piece. So I'm not going to worry about it for this application, but you could always go back through and add a little bit more in there. So once I've got my images selected here, I would go again to Layer, New, Via Copy, and that's going to give me another layer. So here we can see I've got a transparent layer with these the kind of cool logos here, and then I've got my orange layer, and then I've got my background copy. It's really nice to have these labeled the way you want them to be, just because it'll be nice when you get into After Effects or into Premiere to know what they are. So here I'm going to call this logo copy, and here I'm going to call this orange bar. Right. And of course, notice that you could make this little bar again in After Effects really easily. So maybe you wouldn't want to import it. Maybe you would want to just use After Effects to create another shape. But this gives you an idea of how to pull out the logo and have these pieces individual. In the next tutorial, I'm going to show you how to actually animate these in After Effects.